Quality of service is a set of tools and techniques that allow you to optimize your network according to your priorities. There is the single golden setup. It's all about making sacrifices in some areas or situations to benefit elsewhere. Many networking devices have a simplified QoS section so that it's obvious that they tick the check mark, but there could be many nuanced scenarios that those devices might not be able to satisfy. In RouterOS, on the other hand, we don't have a single central QoS tab or section, and we give you multiple ways you could achieve similar outcomes. By playing around, you're more than likely to find a solution that fits your situation. But let's take a step back and understand how QoS came about. There's always a bandwidth limit somewhere. So what do you do when the demand exceeds supply? The most simple approach that a device could take is to simply drop any packets that are in excess of its ability to further process them. But then traffic can also come in short, rapid bursts. That issue is generally solved with simple buffering. Any access gets delayed a little until it can be squeezed into the pipe. Unless you exceed the buffer and then again, the excess has to be dropped. The TCP protocol doesn't mind the dropped packets. In fact, it has a built-in mechanism that uses information about drops to adjust given TCP stream on the sender side. When performing a single download, this optimizes the throughput very well. But in practice, a single end-user device will be running multiple streams of traffic at the same time, and there will be multiple devices and multiple users on the same network. Worst of all, some traffic is time-sensitive. When you're doing video calls or competitive online gaming, you do not want any dropped or delayed packets whatsoever. So how do you deal with this mess? Well, you could limit the speed for all connected devices so that no single device can hog up all of the bandwidth, but then if you have 10 users, each will be experiencing only 1/10 of the full bandwidth. This is one solution, but it is not ideal. If all users and all data streams could take bursts of full bandwidth data transfer when the pipe is free, but scale back when others need to transfer, that would be a much more intelligent solution. Luckily, it is possible thanks to your networking equipment's ability to classify and prioritize traffic so that it can make real-time decisions. What traffic should be let through immediately, what can be held back a little, and what packets can be dropped in the given moment. This more advanced process is usually called queuing and scheduling, but in RouterOS we just call it queuing. There are different algorithms that are commonly used to fine-tune this queuing process, and they will deliver different results. RouterOS lets you take advantage of the most relevant algorithms like FQ, CODL, and CAKE, and can go beyond them, allowing for very custom solutions. But before you configure anything, you have to understand whether you would like to perform quality of service primarily on the switch chip, or are you willing to tax your CPU. If your device is primarily a switch, or you're taking advantage of fast track and hardware offloading, it is a very good idea to stick with the switch chip configuration when it comes to QoS. Now, if you want to find where to configure that, just click on switch and then QoS. Things can get pretty nuanced there. You can actually use this together with ACL rules, but I will have to get into details in another video. Then, when it comes to the CPU handled QoS, we have the queues section. This is the main place where you should handle QoS on a router. But you have to bear in mind that fast track will have to be disabled. Simple queues are the easy way to add rate limits and pick a desirable queuing algorithm. Any queues that you add here will get processed in order similarly to firewall rules. But in addition, every queue can have child queues underneath them too. Interface queues is a place where you can quickly set queuing type for a specific port. By default, most of our devices will just rely on the hardware driver to process traffic at a port level, but you could override it if you like. The queue tree is for slightly lower level queue setups where everything gets processed slightly differently. You do not have the order structure like with simple queues, and receive and transmit directions have to be managed separately. The queue type section allows you to prepare algorithm-specific configurations that you can later use in your queue setup. So that's a quick overview of the queues. These can be really advanced when combined with the firewall mangle ability to mark packets. That means anything that you can match with the firewall, you could send to unique QoS treatment. Funny enough, the firewall has the ability to work with rate limits on its own, so you could use it as a crude rate limiter on its own, although I would not advise it. It's better to let the queuing algorithms to take care of it. Finally, there is one more place in RouterOS where you can handle quality of service. It is called KID control, and here you can assign time and MAC address specific rate limiting. So if you have a kid, you can make sure things get boring for him after bedtime, and maybe he actually goes to sleep on time.